Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. Few years ago I made a video covering a 0.96-inch OLED display with STM32. The display used the SH1106 IC, and it was connected via the I2C. Today I have another OLED display with me. It is SH1106 based 1.3-inch OLED display with I2C pinout. Since the pins are as per the I2C standard, there are only 4 of them available on the board. The SH1106 library can be used with SH1106, but with a very minor modification. Here I have downloaded the previous OLED project, and we will use most of these files in this project. Here I have the modified library files for the SH1106, which we will use in our project. Alright, let's start the Cube IDE and create a new project. I am using STM32F103C8 for this project. Give some name to the project, and click Finish. Let's start with the clock setup first. I am enabling the external crystal to provide the clock. The blue pill has 8 MHz crystal on it, and we will use the PLL to run the system at a maximum 72 MHz clock. Also make sure to enable the serial wire debug. Now go to connectivity, and enable the I2C1. You can see the pin PB6 and PB7 got configured as the clock and data pins. In the parameter setting, set the I2C speed to fast mode, as we need the I2C clock at 400 kHz. That is all the configuration we need. Click Save to generate the project. Let's check the connection before proceeding further. Here you can see the connection between the OLED and the STM32. The OLED is powered with 3.3 volts from the STM32 itself. The clock pin is connected to the pin PB6, and the data is connected to the pin PB7. Now we will copy the SH1106 library files to our project. Copy the C file in the source directory, and header file in the include directory. We will use some other files from the previous old project as well. Let's copy these bitmap, fonts, and animation files in the source directory. Also copy the fonts header file into the include directory. As I said, the SH1106 library is very similar to SSD1306. In fact, I have only made changes here in the initialization commands, and removed the scrolling function, as this IC does not have dedicated hardware scrolling features. Other than this, the library is exactly the same as the SSD1306. In the beginning of this file, you need to define the I2C instance you are using. Also in the SH1106 header file, define the OLED size. The SH1106 IC only supports 132x64 pixels, so we need to make some adjustments while writing the code. Even the slave address for both ICs is the same, so we don't need to worry about that part. Let's understand the function available in this library. The init function will initialize the display, and set the background to black. The update screen function must be called to flush the buffer to the display. After writing the text or drawing pictures, this function must be called to display the updated data. The toggle invert function will invert the display, it will change the black color to white, and white to black. The fill function will fill the entire display with the respective color. If you take a look at the color enumeration, there are only 2 available, black and white. Actually, the white can be even blue or yellow, depending on the color type of the old display. The draw pixel function will set a pixel defined by the X and Y coordinates. The color parameter defines the color of the pixel. The goto function sets the cursor at a location defined by the X and Y coordinates. This function needs to be called before printing a character, or a string on the display. The putC function prints a single character on the display. The second parameter of this function is the fonts that you want to use. The character will be printed at a location set by the function goToXY. The putS function prints an entire string on the display. Next we have the functions to draw lines, rectangles, triangles and circles. Then the clear function will fill the entire display with black color. The on and off functions are used to turn the display on and off. The invert display function will invert the display as per the parameter. If the parameter is zero, the display will remain black background with white text, or if the parameter is anything else, the display will change to white background with black text. At last we have the function to draw the bitmap. The drawing will start from X and Y coordinates. The second parameter is the pointer to the bitmap that we want to draw. Then we have the width and height of the image. So these are all the functions available in the library, we will test them one by one. Let's include the SH1106 header file, and the fonts header file as well. Now in the main function, initialize the display first. Then put the cursor at the beginning of the display. Note that the SH1106 IC supports 132 by 64 pixels, but here we have 128 by 64 display. So we need to center our data, and therefore leave 2 pixels from both ends on the x-axis. Therefore you will always have an offset of 2 on the x-axis. Now we will print hello at the beginning of the display. You can choose from the fonts available in the fonts file. I am choosing this 11 by 18 font. I will find ways to generate more fonts, and if I do find some, I will update the description of this video. So let's pass the address of the font 11 by 18 here. And the color will be 1. We have passed the string to the display buffer, but to print it, we need to call the function updateScreen. Let's build this. We don't have any errors, so let's flash it to the board. You can see the string hello is printed on the display. Now let's print another string. First we will set the cursor to 0 in X and 30 in Y. Then print world at this location. Let's flash it to the board again. You can see both the strings get printed at their respective locations. So we are able to print the strings on the display. Now we will see how to print a number. Let's define a number first. We cannot print the number directly on the display, instead we need to print the equivalent ASCII characters. This buffer will store the equivalent ASCII data for the respective number. We will use sprintf to convert the integer value to the character format, the converted data will be stored in the array. Now let's put the cursor at x0 and y10. Send the buffer using the function puts, and update the screen. Let's build the project once. We need to include the standard IO header file. Also, let's change the buffer type to character type. Alright, let's flash it to the board now. You can see the number is printed on the display. Similarly, we can display the float numbers as well, you just need to change the format in the sprintf function. So we are able to print the strings and numbers on the display. Now we will see the bitmap. The bitmap file we copied from the old project already has the bitmap array in it. But I will once again show how to generate the C array for the bitmap. Here I have a black and white image of the logo. Let's open it in the image editing software. We need to first resize the image to 128 by 64 pixels. Now export the image in the BMP format. The bitmap image is now ready, so we will convert it to the C array. We will use the image converter tool by LVGL. Here select the LVGL version 8. Then select the image from the computer. The color format should be set to indexed 1 bit. Output format should be the C array, and check the big endian format as well. Click convert, and a C file will download. This file is generated according to the LVGL format, but we are only interested in this array. Let's copy it to our bitmap file. Now remove all the LVGL defines from here. Also remove these two lines. We now have the proper C array for the bitmap image. This is the name of the array. Include the bitmap header file in the main file. Now inside the main function, call the draw bitmap function. We will draw the image from the beginning of the display. Pass the array name here, and then the size of the image. Now call the update screen function to display this image. Let's build and flash it to the board. You can see the bitmap has been printed on the display. We can display any bitmap image in the similar way. Now let's see how to display a GIF. We copied this horse animation file from the old project. This file contains 10 different C arrays for the bitmaps. When we run these bitmaps one after another, they produce an animation-like effect. We will see how to generate these arrays from a GIF file. Let's say I want to display this GIF on the OLED screen. We need to first save this image. Now open it with the image editing software. Here you can see we have 6 different images in this GIF. We need to extract these images one by one. Let's resize the GIF to 128 by 64 pixels. Now hide all the images, leaving only one. Then export the image in the bitmap format. Here you can see the first image that we exported. Now hide the first image, and extract the second one. Do the same for other images as well. Now we have all 6 bitmaps, so we will generate the C arrays for them. Select all the 6 images, and click convert to generate the C files. Now copy the array content from these files into a separate file. We now have the data for 6 different bitmap images. Let's include the header file in our main file. After we draw the logo bitmap, give a delay of 2 seconds. Inside the while loop, draw the bitmap for the first image. But clear the display before that, and update the screen afterwards. Now repeat this process for the other bitmap images as well. Let me uncomment this part also, and five a delay of 2 seconds after printing these strings. Alright, let's build and flash it to the board. So we have the text, the logo bitmap, and the horse GIF is playing as well. This is not as smooth as I thought it would be. Let's display this one from the previous old project. Include the horse animation header file. Now in the while loop, draw all 10 bitmaps. Alright, let's build and flash it to the board. Now you can see another GIF, containing another horse. So we were able to print the strings, display the bitmaps, and even managed to display the GIF on the old display. This is it for the video. I hope everything was clear. You can download the code from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.